Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you will fine. So I welcome you to the science class for class 6. So today we are going to learn the remaining thing of first chapter, that is food from where, food where it come from. Okay, so in previous classes, previous class we had discussed food variety, food eaten by living organism. Today we are going to learn the sources of food, the food habit of people, and the some steps to avoid the food storage, food wastage. Okay, so yes, let's get started. Yes, so sources of food, we get the food from both animal as well as from plants. Okay, yes, so just like from plants we get fruits, vegetables, okay, and then potatoes and some other kind of stuff, food. And from animals we get milk, meat, sausage, egg, and the chicken. Okay, yes, so we'll see one by one what are the what other things we get from the plant and we get from the animal. Okay, yes, yes, so plant as a source of food. Okay, so beside that we get many things like cereal, pulses, vegetable, fruits, sugar, tea, coffee, and spices and oil. Also we get it from the plants, and along with these are the eatable things we eat these things. These are the food, but along with these we get many things, many other things from the plant. Okay, like medicine, like paper, then rubber, then what else we get, wood for making furniture, and wood for and what purpose, and for as a fuel for cooking purpose, isn't it? Yes, so we'll see one by one. So cereals, so yes, so cereals. So cereals are the major crop, major plant. Plant provide us cereals. Okay, like some major cereal crop are rice, wheat, maize, and barley. Okay, they are rich in carbohydrate and they provide us the energy. They are the main source of energy. Okay, yes, we get energy. Okay. Yes, and okay, and they are we get it from the grain, that is actually these are the grain, these are called grains. Actually these are food, but it has specific name, that is called a grain. Okay, so we say it as a grain. The next is pulses. So pulses we get it from the leguminous plant. Okay, leguminous plant. Just a minute. Leguminous plant. Okay, what do you mean by leguminous? These leguminous plant have the property that their roots have special property that they fix the nitrogen present in the atmosphere. Means what you mean by fix? They absorb these nitrogen and they mix in the soil, and so they increase the fertility of soil. Whose root? The plant of leguminous plant. Okay, just like pea plant and the gram. Okay, then moong, arahar, okay, arahar, or her, okay, and they are rich in protein. So they are rich in protein. They are rich in protein. Okay, yes. So some example are like we saw that pea, gram, soya bean, groundnut, bean. Okay, yes. The next thing is vegetable. So vegetable like beetroot, spinach, cauliflower. Okay, yes. So they are rich sources of vitamin, mineral, and roughage. Vitamin, mineral, and roughage. Okay. So they are very essential for our body building and for protection from the diseases. Okay, yes. So they the water content is very high in these vegetables. Okay, and their food value is very low. Okay, yes. Then next is fruit. So fruit are also having high content of water. Okay. Yes, so the fruit have a high content so the fruit have high content of water and low food value, but they are also rich in minerals and minerals plus vitamins. Okay, yes. So they are actually they are called fruit because they are usually eaten by raw. They are eaten raw. We do not need to cook them. We can eat them as they are after ripening or sometime raw also we eat them. That is why they are called as a fruit. Okay, yes. The next is sugar. So sugar mainly we get it from the beetroot. Yes, here we have beetroot plus sugar cane. Okay, yes sugar cane. Here you can see the sugar cane field. Yes, sugar cane field. Okay, so they are also the important component in our food. Okay, then we have a tea and coffees. Okay, so tea and coffees. Tea we get it from the leaves of tea plant, and the coffee we get the seeds of a coffee plant. Okay, so they are the beverages. Okay. And they are also a main component of our food. Then we have spices. Okay, like actually the spices they are the flavoring agent. They are used for the tasting purpose. Okay, they are used for the taste purpose and flavor. They do not have a food value. Okay, yes. So some common spices are pepper, then cardamom, then ginger, and then the turmeric chilies. Okay, chili powder, then turmeric. Okay, this turmeric. Okay, then we have saffron. Then you have fennel, then cumin, okay, and so on. Then we have oil plants. We get oil from plants like coconut, soya bean, and the mustard, and this is used for the mainly cooking purpose. Okay, they make our food tasty. Okay, so why we cook our food? To make it easy for digestion. Okay, to make easy for digestion, and also it make our tasty. Okay, it make our food tasty, plus it kill the any harmful germs. If we have any germs present in the raw food, it kill that. Okay, yes. Okay. So next, okay, yes, done. Then we have sources of food from the animal. Okay, yes. So animal are also the main. Yes, they are also. The animal provide us the food in the form of milk, meat, fish, egg, and honey. So we have some milk producing animal like a cow and buffalo. Okay, so yes, we get milk from these animal. Sometime goat and camel also. Okay, then meat yielding animal like sheep, goat, and pig. They are rear for their meat purpose. Okay, and also we get wool from the sheep. Okay, yes, then poultry animal like hen, duck, and turkey. They are rear, hen, duck, and turkey. They are rear for meat as well as for egg purpose. Okay, meat as well as egg purpose. Okay, yes, then fish. And also yes, okay, then the fish it is also a major component of our food. The area which lies near to seas, okay, there it is a regular meal. The fish constitute a regular meal. Okay, yes, so they are rich in protein, okay, and vitamin D. Okay, and yes, in India fish are found in both fresh water. What do you mean by fresh water? It means lakes, pond, and river, and sea water. That means in sea water. Okay, yes. So some example of fresh water fish are Katla. CATLA, Katla, then Labio. Okay, and then some example of sea water fish. Okay, they are Hilsa, then catfish. Okay, yes. Okay, then one more thing you need to remember, that rearing of and management of fish on a large scale is known as pisciculture. PSCICULTURE, pisciculture. What is pisciculture? It is the method of rearing and growing and managing the fish on a large scale. That is called the pisciculture. Okay, then honeybee. So the honey which we get from the insect, we get honey, that they are called as a honeybees. Okay, yes, they suck the nectar. What do you mean by nectar? Nectar are the sweet juices found in a flower. So these bees extract these sweet juices from the flower, and they convert it into honey into nest. This nest is called beehives. Okay, and then the single compound, the whole thing is called beehives, and one single compartment is known as combs, COMBS, combs. Okay, yes. Then the rearing of a honeybee on a large scale is known as apiculture. Okay, apiculture, the process of rearing them. Okay, that is called as apiculture. And the place where they are reared, where they are grown, that place is called apiary. APIARY, apiary. Okay, just like where we the process of Making food is called cooking. But where we cook? In the kitchen. The kitchen is the place where cooking is done. So similarly, the process of rearing honeybees, okay, is called apiculture. But the place where they are reared, that place is called as a apiary. Okay, yes. Now we'll see the next thing, that is food habit of people and some steps to avoid wastage of food. So food habit of people, as we discussed in the earlier, that the people are belongs to many states. They differ from food, they differ the food habit, okay, isn't it? The food habit is mainly because of the availability of food, availability of food. Like the area where the fish are found, okay, the area where the fish are found, okay, so there will be there the fish meal will be the major component, okay, where the place where rice is found, there the rice will be the food habit of people. The where the wheat is found, the food habit of people will be wheat there, okay. Yes, so different parts of our country, the food differ from place to place, okay. Just like here we saw that if you go in southern side, you will find that mostly the rice is used, because rice is being cultivated there. The wheat is not properly grown. Then if you come in India, well, here we grow rice as well as wheat, so we eat. In north India, the people eat rice as well as wheat, okay. Yes, so we'll see some states and their food habit of their people, okay. Yes. Yes. So the people, like in Andhra Pradesh, the food habit of people residing in Andhra Pradesh is like rice, then dry vegetable, then arhar dal, then upma dosa, then pickle. Okay, so these are the main food habits of people of Andhra Pradesh. Okay, yes. Now we'll see the food habit of people residing in Bihar. So they that are like rice, chapati. So Bihar and UP, we have some similar habit of food. Okay, yes. So they eat rice, chapati, okay, then sattu you must have eaten, okay, then dal, then baigan ka bharta, okay, then bhujia, okay, then papad, chutney, and yes, so these are the major food habits of people of Bihar, okay. Then we see the food habits of Gujarat, okay. Yes, so their people used to eat chapati, then rice, then dal, then chutney, okay, and then dokla is the famous food of Gujarat, dokla, okay. If you have seen Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma, you will know better, okay. Then Punjab, the food habit of Punjab, people of Punjab, so it is a makke ki roti, okay. Then paratha, then we have lassi, because there people used to rear many buffaloes, okay, yes. Then gajar ka halwa, okay, yes. So these are the main food habits of people of Punjab. Then Rajasthan, so there the famous food are like bajra, then missi roti, then you have butter, then lassi, okay, so these are the things. Then Tamil Nadu, so usually we say idli, you might have heard and you will be knowing well, idli, sambar, then dosa, rice, okay, banana chips. So these are the major food habits of people of Tamil Nadu, okay. Now we'll see the some steps to avoid a wastage of food. Okay, yes, so usually people at home or at a function, the people do wastage of food, and you know that there is a very gap between people. Some people are very poor, they do not get the square meal, they do not get the food to eat, and there are some people who do wastage of food. So it is necessary to do not waste the food, okay. So what we can do, we should take the food that much we can eat, okay. We should not leave the food in our plate, okay. Yes, we should not keep the food open or uncovered so that it get by damaged by any insect or animal, okay. We can feed animal separately, but we should not allow to destroy it, to waste it, okay. Then if in parties and functions, if the food is remains, so what we can do, we can distribute it to the needy one, okay, or we can give it to the NGOs, and they can distribute it to the needy one, or the people who are not getting, okay. So these are the some steps to avoid wastage of food, okay. Yes, okay. So here you have some questions, so okay, so first let's revise once again what we have learnt, okay. Yes, so we saw that we have some food variety, the people differ, we do not eat same kind of food, we eat different kind of food. Then food eaten by living organism, that is herbivorous, carnivorous, and then the omnivorous, okay, and the autotrophs, they prepare their own food, okay. Then sources of food, that is the animal as well as the sources of food, animal and plant. We get many food from the animal, we get many food from plant. Then food habit of people, we saw that it depends upon the availability of food and the likelihood of food. Okay, people. Okay, then we saw some wastage of some steps to avoid the wastage of food. Now let us see some questions. Okay, so you have to answer these some questions like the question is like which plant give us cereals. Okay, so we get cereals from, yes, tell me, that is the wheat, then rice, then maize, okay, then jowar. Okay, so these are the some crops from which we get cereals. Okay, yes, then we get pulses from like pea, then gram, then arahar, then moong. Okay, yes, then we get vegetables like cauliflower, then cabbage, ladyfinger, then potato, tomato, okay, yes, chili, okay, yes, then oils, we get oils from groundnut, then mustard, then what else, yes, coconut, yes. Then what are some plants which give fruit like mango, banana, then pineapple, then apple, then lychee, and so on. Okay, then spices, what are the some spices or spices plant like we have clove, then ginger, then we have turmeric, okay, yes, then we get sugar, yes, tell me, yes, the sugar cane, then beetroot, these two are used for producing sugar. Okay, then we get tea from the tea leaves, the leaves of tea plant. Okay, yes, so we get tea from the leaves of tea plant. Okay, and the coffee we get from the seeds of coffee plant. Okay, then next, which part of the plant are eaten? Okay, so let's take it out from here, the previous slides. Yes, so if you talk about the cereals, so we eat the grain part, or we can say the fruit part. These are actually the fruit of this plant. Okay, so these are the fruits, but we will not say it's fruit. It is every human being, we cannot say as a man. Okay, it depend upon when it is a small, then if it is child, we call it a child. Okay, when he grow, then it is called a boy, then man, then the old man. Okay, similarly, we cannot say everything as a fruit. It is fruit, but we cannot say it fruit. It is actually called as a grain. Okay, so with the grain is being eaten in cereal plants. Okay, then yes, in pulses we eat the fruit. Okay, yes, okay, the seeds we actually eat the seeds. Okay, yes, then in vegetables we eat here we eat the root. Okay, in the spinach we eat leaves, here we eat root, here we eat the flower, as the name says, cauliflower. Then in mustard we we get the oil from the seeds. Okay, here we eat fruit. Here we are here in sugar cane. We use stem to eating purpose. Okay, here leaves, here seed, here the fruit. Okay, and here the flower sometime and sometime the seed. Okay, in spices sometime we use flower. Okay, and sometime this leaves. Okay, yes. Okay, so the next question is, which of the plant have more than one edible parts? Okay, so like, okay, so let's go to the previous slide. Okay, so here, yes, so here we can use these, here we can use these leaves. Here the stem we can use for our purpose, and the leaves of this sugar cane can be used as a fodder for the animal. Okay, here we use just the fruit. Okay, and in this also we use just fruit. Okay, we cannot use for eating purpose the leaf and the stem. Okay, but here we can use as a human, we can use the grain, and the remaining things can be used for the animal. Okay, and here also if you are eating the root, the leaves can be eaten by the animals. Okay, and here also the leaves can be eaten by the animal. Okay, yes. Then next question, which food item are eaten raw and which one after cooking or boiling? Okay, so mostly the fruits and some vegetables are eaten raw. Okay, and which one after cooking or boiling? So mostly cereals and other things we first cook it, then we eat it. Okay, or we boil it. Okay, yes, so these were the things. So if you have any doubt, you can ask in the below comment section. Okay, you can give your suggestion and any feedback and suggestions. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you so much.